This is Pastor Paul. It's such a joy to be able to fellowship with you by means of this special generational prayer. And I know that as we release the blessing, as we release the anointing, and as we come against the generational curses and those things that Satan has tried to represent in your life as that which will always be a hindrance, whether it is a spiritual legacy or a physical legacy or an emotional legacy that has been passed down from generation to generation, I want you to know that the Spirit of God is about to move in an awesome way, that there is about to be a release of God's delivering power, and that there is about to be a release of covenant anointing into your life. And as we prepare to pray right now, I want you to open your heart, and I want you to allow the Spirit of the Lord, just allow the Spirit of God to flood your life, to penetrate every area of your soul that the enemy has tried to bring the curse and has tried to bring the bondage to. And I know that as we pray and agree together, you're going to feel that release in your spirit. You're going to feel strongholds beginning to come down. You're going to feel an anointing begin to fill those areas of your life where there has been lack and where there has been dysfunction. I want you to get ready to receive, and we're just going to create an atmosphere of worship and praise right now. So open your heart, prepare to receive the generational blessing. Creation, Father of heaven and earth, we come to you now in the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus, the name at which every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. I come to you now, knowing that in your name there is power, knowing that in your name there is deliverance, knowing that in your name there is freedom. I bring to you now every generational curse and every generational pattern of dysfunction and behavior that the enemy has tried to perpetuate through family bloodlines. I bind the hand of the enemy and I curse them back to hell, and I decree that there will be a release of God's healing power, of God's delivering power. Heavenly Father, first of all, I come before you asking that physical legacies be broken. God, that infirmity that is passed through families, health problems that have run in generations, I decree now that there will be a release of generational blessing for healing. I come against high blood pressure. I come against glaucoma. I come against sugar diabetes. I come against strokes. I come against lupus. I come against sickle cell. I come against Parkinson's disease. I come against Alzheimer's. I come against every inherited, every passed down infirmity. I bind it in the name of Jesus, and I decree that the 39 stripes that you took on your back shall be for a release of generational healing. Father, I decree that these infirmities shall not visit the next generation, and I decree that there will be a healing, that there will be a breaking of the curse, that the cycle will be broken in the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus. Lord, I lift it up to you now, and I decree that there will be a touch, there will be a move, there will be a healing, there will be a deliverance in the name of Jesus. I decree it now and I call it done. I decree that healing. I decree that anointing that destroys that physical legacy that is passed down through bloodlines. I bind it in Jesus' name, and I decree the healing power. Lord, I thank you that bodies are being healed, that even babies who are still in the womb, who would ordinarily come out suffering, I decree that they are healed now, and that they will be born healthy, and future generations shall come forth, and there shall be no sign of the generational curse that has been in previous generations. I speak this into the realm of the Spirit, and I decree that there will be a release of that generational blessing now. In the name of Jesus, I destroy physical legacies that have been a curse, and I release the generational blessing of physical restoration in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Abba, Father, I love you. I love you. Again.
Now, Lord, I lift up to you. I lift up to you every spiritual legacy, every generational curse of spiritual legacy that has been passed down. I come against witchcraft. I come against sorcery. I come against those that have dealt with psychics and those who have worked with witchcraft. I bind the powers of hell that have tried to bring a curse in the mind, that have come against the image of self-esteem. I bind the hand of the enemy. I come against the legacy of every relative that has dealt with horoscopes, that has dealt with Ouija boards, that's dealt with any kind of unclean idolatry, and I bind it in the name of Jesus. I take authority over the spirit of fear. I take authority over the spirit of inadequacy. I take authority over the spirit of condemnation, and I decree that there will be a release now in the name of Jesus. Oh, that which I bind on earth is bound in heaven, and that which I loose in the earth is loosed in the heavens. I decree that there will be a release of the anointing in the realm of the Spirit. God, that your people will not be bound by the transgressions of previous generations. God, you said that even to the fourth generation under the old covenant, that the sins of the father would be visited to that fourth generation. You declared that there would be no Moabite who could come into the house of the faithful for at least 10 generations. But Ruth rose up and she broke that curse, and she declared to Naomi, she said, listen, your God shall be my God and your people shall be my people. God, I decree now that whatever curses and whatever spiritual dysfunction, whatever spiritual legacies have negatively impacted your people from previous family members, I decree that that bondage is broken now. And I decree that there will be a liberty and a deliverance in the Holy Spirit. God, even those things that we were not aware of, God, relatives who dabbled in the occult, those who walked in mysticism, and even those who dabbled in spiritualism, God, I decree that there will be a breaking of those curses, that there will be a binding of unclean spiritual influences. I also come against territorial spirits that control areas and that cause people in certain areas to react in certain ways. I come against it now in the name of Jesus, and I decree that no matter the territorial spirit, even as you sent Michael and you delivered unto him the message of power that Daniel received, that the prince of the angels that Michael would war with the prince of Grecia and then with the prince of Persia, I decree that there will be a deliverance from the power of territorial and controlling spirits. God, I decree in homes and marriages that there will be a deliverance now. God, spiritual dysfunction where homes and marriages are unequally yoked. God, where husbands and wives are not walking in the unity of the faith, I come against that spirit. I come against that inequality. God, I decree that there will be a healing and there will be a restoration in homes and families. Satan, you hear my voice. As a prophet of God, I have power over you, and I bind you, I curse you, and the blood of Jesus Christ is against you now. And I decree that there will be a breaking of spiritual influences. There will be a destruction of spiritual strongholds in the name of Jesus, that the actions of previous generations will not be allowed to keep us in spiritual bondage. I come against every unclean, witchcraft, idolatrous influence, and I decree that there is deliverance now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I decree that that deliverance is complete and that the glory of your anointing is setting our spirits free. For your word says, he whom the Son makes free, surely he is free indeed. And now we give you the glory for spiritual legacies. For spiritual legacies being broken. For spiritual curses being broken. And now, Lord, I lift up to you even emotional legacies. God, some of us come from families where dysfunction is the norm. We come from families where arguing and lack of communication is standard procedure. But in the name that is above every name, I bind those spirits and I bind those influences. I decree to your people now that patterns of dysfunction, patterns of sexual dysfunction, even some have been molested as children and they've grown up with a distorted view of sexuality. They've grown up lacking trust. I come against those strongholds now and I decree that those emotional legacies will not carry to the next generation and that your people are being healed and delivered now. God, I give you the glory and I give you the praise that even now there is a release coming, even of hurtful memories, of traumatic incidences that have been seared in the memory. Oh, your word says you make all things new, and I decree now that there will be a release, that there will be a cleansing of the memory, and that the hurt and the pain and the tragedy of those moments will be washed away by the soothing balm of Gilead. For does not your word say that there is a balm in Gilead for the healing, for the breach of your people? And I decree that release now in the name of Jesus, that every social and emotional legacy will be broken. I come against patterns of dependency, drug addiction, those that are bound by alcohol, those that are bound by gambling, those that are bound by pornography and sexual perversion. I decree there is a deliverance. I decree that there is a release now, that the bondage is broken. Oh, again, your word declares that the yoke of bondage is destroyed because of the anointing. I give you the praise and I give you the glory that emotional legacies are being broken. And that even now, the freedom of your spirit, the glory of your anointing is breaking anxiety. It's breaking mindsets that have kept us in bondage. And I decree now that the majesty of your glory, that your power, that your anointing will surround us and flood our lives. Lord, I thank you that from generation to generation, your word is new, your word is fresh, and your tender mercies are fresh and new every morning. And I decree that the future generations, there shall be blessing. I come against even the emotional and family legacy of poverty and dysfunction in marriage, God, where there have been numerous marriages. I decree that that curse and that cycle is broken. I come against all dependencies, even to prescription medication. I come against it now. And I decree that there will be a deliverance, and I decree that there will be a liberty. God, some of us grew up in homes and families where people cursed and argued, and there was never any affection, and now we've grown up with sexual problems, sexual frustrations, and we're unable to express ourselves sexually, even in our marriages, even with our spouse, because of that legacy that has been handed down emotionally. But I decree that this shall be a day of healing, that this shall be a day of deliverance, that this shall be a day of breakthrough, that the power of the enemy is broken now. God, we give you the glory, we give you the praise, and we just lift your name on high, because we know that the generational blessing is being released to your people now, that the glory of your anointing is touching their lives. God, they will look back as they listen to this again and again, and the anointing that is released now, the glory that is released now. Oh, God, I thank you. They're going to experience it over and over and over again. And I thank you now that even the joy of the Lord, that even the power of your spirit is ministering to them now. And Lord, we lift your name. We magnify you now. And we give you the glory because we know that the work is done in the heavens and it's going to be manifested in the natural. God, we thank you that the bondages are broken. We thank you. Oh, we give you the glory. We give you the praise. And we release the generational blessing. We decree wholeness, we decree abundance, we decree healing, we decree prosperity, we decree gifts and callings shall be manifested in your people, that your name might be glorified, that the kingdom of God might go forth. Oh, I give you the praise, I give you the glory. I magnify you now because you are the King of glory. You are the King of glory. And I say that there is none above you. You share your glory with none else. You truly are the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the fairest of 10,000. And we give you the glory. We give you the praise. And we call it done. Would you just rejoice with me now? Would you bask in that anointing? Just let the wave of glory sweep your soul. Oh, who can compare? There is none like him.
With the beauty of the Lord.
Don't you feel his presence right now? Can't you feel his anointing? Can't you feel that glory? Receive this blessing now and know that generational blessing are upon you, upon your children, upon your children's children, and as many as the Lord thy God shall call. God bless you. I love you. In the name of Jesus, be blessed is my prayer.